some after-hours economic data from the region. Hong Kong's economy expands by 3.3% in the second quarter from a year earlier. That's faster than the 2.7% growth in the first quarter of 2024. Its government says growth should continue in the remainder of the year. It kept its full-year economic growth target between 2.5% and 3.5%. Hong Kong, a major financial hub, has been struggling to bounce back after a three-year COVID-19 lockdown. Meanwhile, in Taiwan, its statistics authority lowers its growth forecast for the economy, citing weaker-than-expected exports. It now sees GDP expanding by 3.9% this year, just a tad slower than its previous projection of 3.94%. This is as the agency sees exports growing by just 8.71% this year, compared with its earlier forecast of 10.06%. That's despite an AI boom that has boosted demand for tech products. Taiwan's trade-driven economy is a key link in the global technology supply chain for companies such as Apple and NVIDIA. It is home to the world's biggest contract chip maker, TSMC. The Philippine Central Bank sees climate change negatively impacting the country's economy in the long run. In its 2023 sustainability report, the BSP estimated 7.6% of the country's GDP would be affected by damages from climate change by 2030. Now, this number is seen to rise further to 13.6% by 2040. The BSP noted the Philippines incurred over 24 billion pesos in damage due to natural extreme events last year. The BSP also said temperature shocks could drive inflation up by 0.46 percentage points in the short run. Inflationary impacts can go up to 0.79 percentage points across a longer period. Central Bank Governor Eli Remolona Jr. maintains a climate-resilient economy and financial stability are mutually reinforcing outcomes. He vows to unlock finance for adaptation measures towards a whole-of-nation approach to climate resilience efforts. Indonesian President Joko Widodo touts his economic and infrastructure successes at his final State of the Nation address. Jokowi, as he is popularly known, highlighted the country's economic record, pointing to a consistent growth rate of 5% despite global headwinds.
Regions in eastern Indonesia, such as Papua and Maluku, in fact, have been able to grow above 6%, and North Maluku above 20%. Inflation has also remained in check at around 2 to 3%, as many countries have been experiencing an extraordinarily high inflation rate. Some have even recorded more than 200% inflation rate.
The leader of the Southeast Asian nation will end his term in October with a strong economic record. But he faces criticisms on the weakening of Indonesia's judiciary and anti-corruption body. There's no need to close borders due to Mpox. That's according to the World Health Organization and the International Federation of the Red Cross. Their statements come as the first cases of the disease have been detected outside Africa. Both Sweden and Pakistan have confirmed at least one infection each, which comes just days after the WHO declared Mpox a global public health emergency.
From IFRC side, we do stand with what is recommended under international health regulations, which is that there's no need to close borders when we are in disease outbreaks. Diseases don't recognize borders. People will continue to cross a border, whether it is a legal crossing or an illegal crossing. It doesn't stop a disease from spreading.
It's about knowing that you have it, knowing what to look for, knowing how to separate each other and to do proper contact tracing and not being afraid. So there's always a balance, but not being sort of terrified. It's more a matter of shutting down the infection so that those who are most at risk from severe illness, the young, the immunosuppressed, don't get infected.